What is pharmacogenomic testing and how can a pharmacist use it to improve patient outcomes? Find out next. Hi, I'm Blair Thielemeyer, and I work with pharmacists who want to build and grow their advanced clinical services. Today, I want to talk to you about pharmacogenomic testing. So pharmacogenomic testing is identifying genes that may affect enzymes responsible for hepatic metabolism of certain medications. So back in pharmacology and kinetics, you may remember learning about the cytochrome P450 enzymes. Those enzymes are some of the ones that we look at in a pharmacogenomic test. In addition, we also look at HLA A and B, which the presence of those alleles may indicate hypersensitivity to carbamazepine or phenytoin. We also look at OPRM1s, which in, for my genotype specifically shows a decreased sensitivity to analgesic, but it could go either way. We also look at the COMT gene, which indicates whether or not the body is producing enzymes that can clear dopamine and norepinephrine from the synapse. We also look at SLCO1B1, which tells us if the patient is more at risk for statin-induced myopathy. And for thrombosis risk, we can look at genes that code for factors 2 and 5. As far as Cpt codes, there are no Cpt codes that code specifically for pharmacogenomic testing. The patient can be referred to the pharmacist or to the physician for pharmacogenomic testing based on the medications that they're on and based on their diagnosis. Some impactful activities for a pharmacist wanting to offer pharmacogenomic testing either in their community pharmacy setting or in a physician's office setting is, number one, in collaboration with the practice to create a formulary of drugs that would benefit from a pharmacogenomic test. Number two, use pharmacogenomic testing in practices to offer annual wellness visits or chronic care management services so you could have an ongoing impact on that patient's care and continue to use the test throughout the life of the patient. Or number three, if you're seeing patients and giving them the results of their pharmacogenomic test in a physician's office setting under collaborative practice, you can bill for the pharmacist's interpretation using the incident to billing codes. To refer back to the incident to billing criteria, check out our last video on incident to billing. So if this video was helpful to you, please consider subscribing to our YouTube channel and sharing it with a colleague. And if you're interested in learning more about advanced clinical pharmacy services, check out our website at btpharmacyconsulting.com.